Welcome back to another episode of Cooking with Keith. I'm your host, Chef Keith, and today we're going to be doing one of our most popular new dishes at the restaurant. It's actually, instead of a veal saltimbocca or a chicken saltimbocca, it's a pork saltimbocca. We're using wonderful Iberico pork from Spain. And we have three little medallions here. We're going to show you how to pound it out. And we're going to use some fresh sage and some lovely prosciutto di Parma. We have sliced in our own slicer, so we just need a little bit for each one, less than a half an ounce for each piece of pork medallion. And we're going to pan saute it, a little bit of olive oil and unsalted butter. And then we will finish the sauce with a little bit of lemon juice, white wine, and a little veal stock. We have homemade veal stock here. It's kind of jelly-like right here, and it'll melt nicely in the pan. And then we'll season with salt and fresh ground pepper and finish it off with a little bit of fresh chopped parsley. So we shall get going, and we'll also serve it a side dish of some of our house-made pappardelle noodles that we make every day here. And let's get going, shall we? So first we will get a little trick here. We'll get a gallon bag, gallon food bag, and we will get our sage off to the side, and we'll isolate one piece of pork at a time to get it away from the others, and we'll simply gently pound it with a nice round meat mallet and heavy duty. And we'll simply get that to about a fifth of an inch thick. We'll move that over, do the next one. And we're pounding out the meat because if it's too thick, it's gonna be almost like a steak, and it'll be just a little too tough in your mouth, because this is a very fast preparation in the saute pan. So you want it to be really thin so it gets tender, and pounding it out also will get it more tender and break the fibers down. And there. Now that we have this, we could just simply throw this away, and we will arrange our slices side by side. We will lightly season with a little bit of sea salt and a little cracked pepper. And now we will put our fresh sage leaves. One is sufficient on each one. Put it there. And lastly, one more. And then we'll get our prosciutto that we've sliced very thin, pretty paper thin, and we'll just kind of lay it over. I have two little pieces. I'll put on one slice there, and over here the same. And actually, we'll get that pounder again. We'll get another bag, and I like to just kind of seal everything by pounding it one more time with everything together, and it helps it stay together without the use of a toothpick, which I find cumbersome. And we'll do that, get rid of that one as well. And now we're ready to flour. I'd put just a little bit of flour if you were allergic to gluten or didn't want to have gluten or gluten sensitivity. You could simply leave this part off, but it does help the pork get a lot more crispy. And so we'll start our pan. I'll start on high right now just to get it hot quickly, and then we'll turn it down to about medium, and we'll get everything ready. I'm going to go ahead and flour just the top side. I only flour the top side with the prosciutto, and I cook prosciutto side down first. The main thing is to get the prosciutto crispy. That's what we were doing here at the restaurant, getting it nice and crispy. And again, there's no need for a toothpick. You just be careful with it. You just stay careful and not let it fall apart. And that, we'll do that. We'll put that over there. And we're going to the medium of fat that we're going to use is a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. And just a tab of cold, unsalted butter. There we go. And I'm going to use a little tray. So what we're going to do is when the pork is actually sufficiently cooked on both sides, we're going to take it out, and then we'll deglaze with white wine and lemon juice to start the sauce. All I know is that saltimbocca means jump in your mouth, saltare, from the verb saltare. So The flavors do jump in your mouth. You've got a lot of nice pressed sage, and we're gonna turn that fat down a little bit. And we're gonna go ahead and start putting our, start putting our pork medallions in. So now we're going to check our pork medallions. They're not quite crispy enough yet, so we're going to let them go just a little bit more. Almost there. It looks like this one's getting nice and crisp. I'm going to just turn it over. Same for this one's good. And they're all getting good. And we're just going to let them sit here for about 30 seconds just to make sure the other side is getting done. And this is a smaller piece, so I'll take this one out first, and we'll just put it on a little plate just to let it rest. It's going to stay nice and hot, putting them next to each other. And the sauce is very quick, so you'll see it's a very quick sauce to do. So I'm just going to get rid of the excess oil. We'll just take that away and throw it away. And now we're going to turn this down real low. And we're going to deglaze with a little white wine. I'm just using a nice Pinot Grigio from Italy here. I'm gonna put about a third of a cup, and it's already sizzling away and reducing. And so I like to put a little bite of acidity in there, so I'm gonna put a little bit of squeeze of lemon juice. And I'm also going to just put a little light, just a pinch of salt, and some fresh ground pepper. This is black pepper, by the way. And I'm going to turn that heat up just a little bit more again to reduce it a little faster. And in the meantime, we have our fresh-made pappardelle noodles. And you can make these with, we use our own house recipe is 500 grams of 00 pasta flour. And to each 100 grams, we add one whole large egg. But in addition, we add three extra yolks. And so it's a pretty good ratio of egg to flour. So we think it has a little bit less of a insulin impact because of all the protein from the egg, so it's kind of a not quite such a white flour pasta. So it's nice to know that. And we're going to go ahead and get this pappardelle in. It only takes about 2 minutes to cook to an al dente and be nice and tender. I'm just putting them in one by one to make sure that they don't stick. I'm going to turn the heat up a little bit on that. And I've already salted the water. It's just about a quart of water with about a teaspoon of salt. So this is reducing nicely. You can see it's bubbling. It's getting thicker with the meat juices. And then one other tip is I take the meat juices that have accumulated. You can see these. They're delicious. So just put that right back into the sauce. And lastly, we'll put a little bit of our veal stock, our homemade veal stock that we make here at the restaurant. And I'm going to put about 2 teaspoons. And I will let that go on high heat now to really get going. And as you can see, this is a fairly fast dish, so it's kind of fun to do if you just do the prep work and get your pork pounded out and get a few. There's two, three, four people. And this is a single serving, so I'm using three. So you'll see once it gets down to about maybe another minute of a high heat, it'll be more syrupy and glistening. It'll be really good reduction, a really nice concentrated flavor there. So we're almost there. I'm going to swirl it around a little bit. Let the fire do its job in the surface area. And our pasta, I'm going to move it around just to make sure it's perfect, not sticking. And what we'll do is we'll have a nice warm plate. What we'll do is we'll put our pork right back in there, along with any other accumulated juices. And we'll simply just move it back and forth and let it get some of that sauce on the underbelly of it. And again, the pork is pretty much cooked because it's very thin, so it's not raw at all. You can see on the bottom side, it's nice and cooked. So we're going to go ahead and turn that fire off, and we're going to plate. We're going to put one here, one right next to it, slightly overlapping, and one here. And a neat little trick I like to do is we'll simply pour it right over, and it makes about 2 tablespoons of sauce, maybe just a tablespoon and a half. But from here, we'll leave that residue of the sauce, and it's a wonderful medium for our pasta. So we'll turn that down a little bit. I might add just a little more. It's drying up a bit, so I'm going to put just a little more veal stock. And we'll actually put just a little bit of this pasta water in there, maybe a tablespoon. There we go. And that'll make it nice and kind of a sticky, nice sauce. And this has been going for about 2 minutes, so it's probably just perfect. Here we'll go ahead and take it out and put it into our pan sauces. We'll turn this off, turn this up, and we'll just simply let it get happy with all those lovely sauces in there. Delicious. And now we'll put a little parsley, just a pinch of salt, and we'll simply put it on the plate next to the pork. We'll turn our heat off, and we'll just kind of twirl it around and get a nice nest of pappardelle here. And put a little Parmesan, pre-grated Parmesan. You can just really put it over just everything there. It's delicious. And we'll put that there. And we'll finish off with just a little more parsley. And there you have a lovely pork Saltimbocca dish. We've been serving this a lot at Valeria Restaurant for the last month, and people have been going crazy for it. Really, it's our best seller now. For a non-pasta dish, it's our number one protein that we sell here now. So it's a delicious dish. It's got multiple layers of flavor with the sage and the prosciutto and the nice, wonderful Iberico pork loin from Spain that we pound out nice and thin. And I can't think of a better accompaniment than fresh homemade pasta. And now the fun part. We get to taste it. Give it a little go here. Wow, really good intense flavors of the sage is really shining through, and the prosciutto is lightly crispy, and it's just a delicious dish. The pork is really tender because we pounded it out so thin, and with that sauce, just a little sauce, but it's very concentrated and very, very delicious. I would please try this at home. It's delicious. That's really good. And if it's hard to find Spanish pork loin, any good, I usually get some sort of an organic pork loin from the store. And I would just shave it about a half inch thick and then do your pounding and get it down to about a fifth to a quarter of an inch and it'll be perfect. This is a lovely dish. I'm gonna taste some of that pasta as well. And the pasta is really good with the fresh parsley and the Parmesan. At our restaurant, we actually would recommend, in fact, our recommended wine with this is Vitticchio Chianti Classico. It's a lovely Sangiovese mainly, so it's a great, this is an Italian dish, even though it uses Spanish pork, it's you can easily use Italian pork if you could find it, or simply just use veal. Veal's the traditional one that I'm more aware of from Rome, and I believe it's generally a Roman dish, veal saltimbocca vitello, saltimbocca di vitella. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and share it with anyone. We'd love to hear from you. If you have any dishes you would like for us to do, please do leave comments. We do read them all. Thank you very much, and buon appetito.